ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். டுடே இஸ் தி எயித் டே ஆஃப் மணவாள் மாமுனிகள் திருநக்ஷத்திர மகோத்சவம். இட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ பிள்ளை லோகாச்சாரியர் திருநக்ஷத்திர மகோத்சவம் டே 5 இன் ஸ்ரீ பெரும்புதூர். ப்ரீவியஸ்லி வி என்ஜாய்ட் தி history and glories of Pillalokacharya briefly. Now we will go through his granthams, his divine works, and understand them a little bit. Pillalokacharya is glorified as Paramakarunika by Manavala Mamunigal. That is most merciful. The reason for this is Emperuman gave us the confidential principles himself, and subsequently the same principles was transmitted orally through our Acharya Parampara. From Emperuman, it came through Alvars, and then Acharyas such as Nathamunigal, Alavandar, Emperumanar, and so on. But the confidential principles were only orally transmitted by them, and they were not documented exclusively as granthams. As Rahasya Granthams. Pillalokacharya was the one who took pains in gathering all those valuable information, confidential principles, and documenting them in Rahasya Granthams. It is well known that he has compiled 18 Granthams, which are popularly known as Ashtadasa Granthams. Most of them relate to Rahasya Trayam, which is nothing but Tirumantram, that is the Ashtakshara Mantram, Dvaya Maha Mantram, and Gita Charma Shlokam. These three confidential principles are explained to us as part of our Pancha Samskaram. When one undergoes Pancha Samskaram under an Acharya, the Acharya gives these mantras to the individual, and one is the Shishya or the disciple who accepts Pancha Samskaram also need to inquire from either his own Acharya or learned scholars on these three important matters and understand the purport of all these three. Pillalokacharya compiled many of his granthams explaining these three principles, which are known as Rahasya Trayam. Yadrichika Padi, Shriyapadi Padi, முமுக்ஷுப்படி, பரந்தபடி, தனி பிரணவம், தனித்வயம், தனிச்சரமம், ஆல் ஆர் எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங் திஸ் ரகசியத்ரயம். தெர் ஆர் ஆல்சோ அதர் கிரந்தம்ஸ் சச் அஸ் அர்த்த பஞ்சகம், தத்துவத்ரயம், தத்துவசேகரம், சாரசங்கிரகம், அச்சிராதி, பிரமேயசேகரம், சம்சார சாம்ராஜ்யம், பிரபன்ன பரித்ராணம், நவரத்ன மாலை, and Navavida Sambandham. All of these explain intricate meanings of our Sampradayam, which is founded on Vedantam. Finally, as an epitome of all his works, Sri Vachanabhushanam stands out as a beautiful grantham explaining the concept of considering acharya as the means and as the goals. So these 18 granthams were blessed by Pillalokacharya for the sake of everyone. It is said that one who is bitten by the snake of the samsaram will be relieved from this by the medicine, nectarian medicine, in the form of the literature given by Pillalokacharya. Pillalokacharya's works are considered as the medicine for one's disease of being bound in the samsaram. Among all his granthams, three granthams are considered as Kalakshepa granthams. Kalakshepa grantham means one studies the text along with its commentaries under the guidance of an acharya or a scholar, where the scholar or the acharya reads out the text and also reads out the commentary line by line and explains all the necessary aspects and meanings of those granthams. Here, Pillalokacharya's Mumukshupadi, Tattvatrayam and Sri Vachanabhushanam are considered as Kalakshepa granthams by our elders. Manavala Mamunigal, who is known as Vishatavak Shikamanigal, Vishatavak Shikamani means one who has very apt language and presentation skills. Manavala Mamunigal blessed us with commentaries for all these three important granthams of Pillalokacharya. With this commentary, we will get utmost clarity in all these principles which are explained in these granthams. Now, let us understand briefly the content of each of these important granthams. First, we will see Mumukshupadi. Mumukshupadi is a wonderful grantham explaining the meanings of Rahasyatrayam, which is Tirumantram, Dvayam and Charamashlokam. Mumukshupadi literally means how a Mumukshu will lead his life. Mumukshu is the one who is desirous to get liberation. Here, liberation means, in this context, being freed from this bondage in this material world, reaching Paramapadam and engaging in eternal service to Sriman Narayanan. So those who are interested in this goal need to understand this grantham clearly and put it in practice in their lives. In this grantham, there are three prakaranams, there are three sections. The first section explains Tirumantram, that is Ashtaksharam. The second section explains Dvaya Mahamantram. And the third section explains Charama Shlokam, which is Sarva Dharman Parityajya Shlokam, which is in the end of Sri Bhagavad Gita, which was mercifully spoken by Bhagavan Krishna himself. In the first section, in Tirumantra Prakaranam, Pillalokacharya first explains that this Tirumantram was revealed by none other than Bhagavan himself in Badrikashramam, where he assumed the form of an Acharya and a Shishya. Narayana Rishi is the Acharya and Nara Rishi is the Shishya. Both of them are incarnations of Bhagavan himself. It is understandable that Bhagavan is the foremost of Acharyas, and hence he assumes the role of Acharya here too. But why would he assume the role of Shishya as well, disciple as well? That is to establish that it is not just instructions given by Bhagavan, but he also puts it in practice and shows it by following it as a Shishya. Thus, everyone will have confidence in what is being conveyed instead of just seeing it as an instruction which is theoretical without practice. Subsequently, the glories of Tirumantram is explained. Pillalokacharya highlights the presence of two types of mantras, Vyapaka mantras and Abhyapaka mantras. Vyapaka mantra means one which highlights Embaruman's omnipresence, all pervasive nature, which basically highlights his supremacy. And Abhyapaka mantras explain Bhagavan's forms, qualities, activities, and so on. Here, the importance of Vyapaka mantras is highlighted, Narayana mantra, Vasudeva mantra, and Vishnu mantra being Vyapaka mantras is highlighted, and among these three, Narayana mantra being the foremost and most important is also explained here. Subsequently, the Tirumantram, the Ashtakshara mantram, is explained in great detail, summarizing that Atma, the soul, is totally dependent on Embaruman, Bhagavan, and its only goal is to serve the Lord. After explaining Tirumantram, in the next Prakaranam, Dvaya Mahamantram is explained by Pillalokacharya. Dvaya Mahamantram has two parts. The first part contains how one performs surrender to Bhagavan through the Purushakaram or recommendation of Sri Mahalakshmi. Because of Mahalakshmi's total dependence on Sriman Narayana, and because Sriman Narayana is totally attached to Sri Mahalakshmi, due to this very intimate relationship between Bhagavan and Tayar, the chetanas, the souls, are uplifted by their grace. In the beginning of the Dvaya Prakaranam, Pillalokacharya also explains what are the expected qualities of a Sri Vaishnava. He highlights very important principles in this first point itself. So this Dvaya Mahamantram is explained in great detail. The first part contains surrender of the soul at the divine feet of Bhagavan through Mahalakshmi. The second part contains the Atma's request or prayer to engage him in eternal kaikaryam at the divine feet of Sriman Narayana and Sri Mahalakshmi. So the process, the means is explained in the first part of Dvaya Mahamantram, and the goal is explained in the second part of Dvaya Mahamantram. In the third prakaranam, Charma Shlokam is explained. Pillai Lokacharya highlights that it is known as Charma Shlokam because it explains the Charma Upayam. That is, Bhagavan is explaining the ultimate means to attain him, which is Sharanagati. And it is because of this shlokam is called Charma Shlokam. The Charma Shlokam has two parts. The first part explains the surrender which was explained in Dvaya Mahamantram. It is an elaboration of what is explained there, that when we surrender to Bhagavan, how should it be done? That is what Bhagavan says here, Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mam Ekam Saranam Vraja. He says that one should give up everything else, attachment towards all other means, all other upayams, and pursue Bhagavan only. Similarly, the second part of Charma Shlokam explains when one intends to do Kaikaryam service to Sriman Narayana and Sri Mahalakshmi, one's hurdles need to be removed first. And Bhagavan guarantees in Charma Shlokam that for the one who surrenders, he will remove all that hurdles, all those hurdles himself. In this manner, Charma Shlokam explains in detail what is explained in Dvaya Mahamantram. There is an underlying connection between Tirumantram, Dvayam and Charma Shlokam. For example, in Tirumantram, Sri Mahalakshmi's name is not explicitly available, but in Dvaya Mahamantram, it is explicitly available. What is explained in Tirumantram is explained further in Dvaya Mahamantram, which is elaborated in Charma Shlokam. Thus, this Mumukshupadi explains Rahasya Trayam in a beautiful manner, in an elaborate manner. Pillalokacharya already compiled Shriyapati Padi, Yadrichika Padi and Parandapadi, all of those explaining about Rahasya Trayam. Finally, he compiled Mumukshupadi because he was still unsatisfied with those three works. He wanted to make one complete work which could be used by everyone to understand the principles easily. Also, the points which were missed in the previous granthams were included in Mumukshupadi, and hence this Mumukshupadi, being the most consistent and most complete one, is held as a Kalakshepa Grantham by our elders. Next, we will see about Tattvatrayam. In Vedantam and in our Sampradayam, three principles are mainly highlighted: Tattva, Hita, Purusharta. Tattva means understanding the reality, the entities which are present and their relationships. That is, the entities Chit, Achit and Ishvara. Chit is sentient beings. Achit is insentient object, and Ishvara is Bhagavan, God. The relationship between Chit and Bhagavan, as Chit being the servitor and Bhagavan Ishvara being the master. All of these come under the Tattva aspect. Hita explains the means, that is, how Chit can reach Bhagavan, and Purushartha explains the goal, which is what does the Atma do after reaching Bhagavan? What is the nature of the activity? And what is the goal which is attained after reaching Bhagavan? Among these three principles, Tattvatrayam focuses on the Tattva aspect. This Grantham, Tattvatrayam, also has three prakaranams or three sections. The first section is Chit section, Chit Prakaranam. Here, the principle of Atma is explained in detail. Atma being innumerable, Atma being a sentient entity, that is, Atma having consciousness, are all explained here. The three types of Atmas, that is Nitya, eternal associates of Bhagavan in Paramapadam, Mukta, those Atmas who were freed from bondage and reached Paramapadam, and finally Baddhas, those who are bound in this material world, are explained in detail. Atma being different from body, mind, intellect, senses, prana, that is vital life, air, etc., are also explained in this section in detail. Atma being a product of knowledge, and Atma having knowledge, is also explained. These are the two types of jnana or knowledge which are explained. First one is dharmic jnana, which is the consciousness which makes up the Atma itself. And then there is dharma bhuta jnana, which is the knowledge of the soul, which is an attribute of the soul. Atma is made of knowledge and it also has knowledge. The difference between dharmic jnana and dharma bhuta jnana is explained in detail in this section. Subsequently, in the next prakaranam, achit is described. Achit means matter, insentient object. Three types of achit is explained. Shuddha Sattva, which is pure goodness or objects in the mode of pure goodness, which are seen in Paramapadam in the spiritual world. Mishra Sattva, the matter which is in mixed mode of goodness and other aspects, which we see, whatever we see in this material world is made of Mishra Sattva. And finally, Kala Tattva, the principle of time, which is also explained as Achit. So these three are the main categorization of Achit, that is Shuddha Sattva, Mishra Sattva and Kala. Further, the variegated nature of matter is also explained in this section. Subsequently, Pillalokacharya explains the Ishvara Tattvam, that is Bhagavan, Bhagavan's forms, many qualities, his true nature are all explained first. Subsequently, he explains the five states of Bhagavan. First, Param, which is his form or state in Paramapadam. Second, Vyuha. Vyuha is his state. Vyuha being the state of his presence in Milky Ocean. Vibhava is the state of his incarnations, how he assumes many different forms. And the Vibhavavatarams, his incarnations, are classified mainly into two categories, Mukhyavatara and Gaunavatara. Mukhyavatara is where he himself appears as Varaha, Narasimha, Rama, Krishna, and so on. Gauna avataras are where he presents his special abilities, his own potency, onto some jivatmas to get to accomplish certain tasks. And then the fourth state of his being, the antaryami, is explained, where he is the indwelling soul of every entity. And finally, his archavataram are his forms in temples, homes, mutts, etc. is explained. Among all these five states or five forms, it is also explained how the archavataram is the greatest. In Paramapadam, due to his mercy, everyone present there is already in pure state. So there is no scope for him to show his qualities such as Saulabhyam, Vatsalyam, and so on. For example, Vatsalyam means to accept one's faults as good quality. In Paramapadam, we don't have anyone who is having faults. So there is no scope for Bhagavan to show his Vatsalyam there. Similarly, he is present there to be approached by everyone, and everyone is already great. But Saulabhyam is a quality where he makes himself easily approachable by even the most lowly persons. That is only possible in this world, material world. So, in the Archavataram, in the deity form, Bhagavan is making himself available for the benefit of everyone, and that makes him very great in this particular form. Thus, Bhagavan's nature, qualities, forms, etc. are explained in detail in the Ishvara Prakaranam. This Tattvatrayam is also called as a short Bhashyam. Sri Bhashyam is a grantham, a commentary for Brahma Sutram. The Sri Bhashyam was compiled, authored by Emperor Ramanujar himself. The Sri Bhashyam contains the most important principles from Vedantam. As this Tattvatrayam Grantham gives the same meanings in brief, it is called as Kutti Bhashyam or a small Bhashyam. This must be learnt by everyone who is eager to know about the truth. Next, we have Sri Vachana Bhushanam. Just like an ornament made with gems, precious stones, will be called as Ratna Bhushanam, the ornament which was made with the words of Purvacharyas is called as Sri Vachana Bhushanam. This Sri Vachana Bhushanam is a beautiful grantham compiled by Pillai Lokacharya, with the help of the words of our Purvacharyas and the principles which were given by our Purvacharyas. This Grantham presents the highest principle of depending totally on the mercy of Acharya. This Grantham is explained in two ways. In one method, it is split into six sections. In another method, it is, in another view, it is split into nine sections. First, we will see how it is split into six sections. In the first section, Sri Mahalakshmi Thayar's Purushakaram is glorified. Purushakaram means recommending for someone. As Thayar, Pirati, is totally dependent on Bhagavan, and as Bhagavan is totally attached to Pirati, Bhagavan will never say no to Pirati's recommendation. So, the greatness of Sri Mahalakshmi Thayar is explained in the first section. In the second section, Bhagavan being the means, that is, his being the Siddhopayam or established means, is greatly glorified. In the third section, those who pursue Bhagavan as the means, their glories are explained. In the fourth section, how such glorious people will serve their acharyas is explained. In the fifth section, Bhagavan's Nirhetuka Kripa, that is, unconditional grace or causeless mercy, is explained in detail. And in the sixth section, Acharya being the ultimate means and, of course, the ultimate goal is also explained in the sixth section. Next, we will see how this Grantham is split into nine sections. First two sections are similar to the previous explanation. The first section talks about Sri Mahalakshmi being the Purushakaram. Her glories are explained. In the second section, how Bhagavan being the means is explained and the glories of that is explained. In the third section, how other means such as Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga are no way comparable to Bhagavan being the means is explained. For example, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, all of these have many limitations, such as one who pursues these yogas will always have that free, independent thought, thinking that he is the doer of these particular yogas. Secondly, these means, these yogas will not give the result immediately. The result will come over time after many, many births, possibly. There are many other limitations like that. But in the case of Bhagavan being the means, because one who surrenders to Bhagavan is totally dependent on Bhagavan, there is no independent thought in that individual. Similarly, Bhagavan being omnipotent and one who is Satya Sankalpa, which means all his desires will be true, the moment he desires that a person should be uplifted, he will be uplifted. There will be no delay. In the fourth section, the glories of Prapannas are the surrendered ones who accept Bhagavan as the means. Their glories are explained in the fourth section. In the fifth section, the Prapannas Nitya Anushtanam, that is the daily routine of a Prapanna, of a surrendered person, is explained in detail. In the sixth section, an Acharya who is perfect, his qualities and his routine, his practice, his conduct is explained. In the seventh section, the qualities of a good disciple are explained. In the eighth section, Bhagavan's Nirhetuka Kripa, that is unconditional grace, is explained. And in the ninth section, that is the final section, Acharya being the means and the goal is explained in detail. This is called as Charama Paramanishtai, the ultimate state of existence, that is being totally dependent on the Acharya. Thus, the Sri Vachanabhushanam presents the most important principles of our Sampradayam, that too the highest principle of Acharya's grace, is explained beautifully. Manavala Mamnikal compiles Upadesha Ratinamalai to reveal the glories and the principles of Sri Vachanabhushanam. Such is its greatness. So we have seen the literary contribution, the Granthams mercifully given by Pillai Lokacharya to us. Let us meditate upon these Granthams and the divine feet of Pillai Lokacharya. Let us look forward to the Tirunakshatra Mahotsavam of Manavala Mamunigal and Pillai Lokacharya, which are approaching very fast. Alvar Emberumana, G.R. Thiruvadigale Saranam, G.R. Thiruvadigale Saranam.
Please download our Koyil, KOYIL app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store to listen to or download Upanyasams like these. Our website portal is koyil.org. Koyil.org.